be started to have multi-user mode with networking than single-user mode. Okay. Now, if you wanted to change something here, like say you wanted to start some service and run level one, or have some other service killed and run level three, then what you would do is you would change the S, the leading S on this file, to a K, and then that would kill that service. And you have to be careful of one more thing, that there's this sequence number after the letter. Okay, so K03, K20, K20, K46, K50. K3 is going to be done first, then the K20s, then the K46, then the K50, and so on. This is just an ordering for the system to know which order to kill things. And the same for the S's. This is the order to start things. So if you're going to add something to this list to start it up when you go into run level 3, be careful to understand what it depends on and make sure that it starts after the stuff that it depends on. Okay? So that's the structure of all these RC directories. They're basically all the same in basic structure. They have some Ks in the front, some files corresponding to K, which corresponds to killing services, and files that start with S, which corresponds to services that must be started to enter that run level. Now, another important file in this whole startup process is a file up in the Etsy directory called initTab. Okay, this file is just another piece of the whole startup puzzle. Okay, and up in the front of the file, it describes all the different run levels, and you can see here that it says level 4 is unused in Red Hat. Like I said, that level 4 varies from system to system. One of the next things it shows is what the default run level for the system should be, and here it's saying that the default run level for this system is run level 5, which is the multi-user mode with X Windows. Now, if you want to change the run level permanently, you just go into here and you change this 5 to 3 or 2 or whatever you want to change it to, and then that will be the run level for your system once you shut down the system and reboot. Okay? So, and the system will always boot into that run level until you change the number in the initTab file. And as you go down through this file, you'll see stuff, what should start at level 0, what should start at level 1, and so on down here. This should be run in every run level, it's saying. Down below, you'll see that there's some Getty programs, these GetTTY programs. These are just text-based login programs. Okay, and what this really is like, when you see that login prompt for you to type, that's actually a program running. And it says, okay, give me your login name, you give it your login name, you give it the password, and then it runs a little program that verifies to make sure your login name and password are valid, and then it logs you onto the system. So that little thing that prompts you for your login and your password is a program that's called a Getty or a GetTTY, and that's running at every run level. Okay, you need that whether you're in single user mode or multi-user mode with X Windows and so on. Now, something that you might want to do actually is change the run level temporarily instead of change it permanently like we saw that you could do in the initTab file. So to change it temporarily, use the telinit command. Okay, and what you would do is you would follow telinit by the number of the run level that you want to switch to. Now, if I hit enter here, what would happen is I would lose my X Windows screen here. I would actually be logged off, and then I would get a login prompt, like that Getty prompt, on a text-based screen. I would log in, and I would just have text access to my computer. I would have no Windows, no mouse, none of that stuff. Okay, that's what Telinit 3 would do. I won't do it because the screen's really ugly, and I don't want to show you all that stuff. I just want to show you how you would do this. This is a really useful trick to have up your sleeve when you're learning X Windows and you're messing with the configuration files. Because a lot of times what might happen is you mess with the configuration file and X Windows won't start anymore, but it also doesn't just like end gracefully. It like tries to start, it fails, it flickers, it tries to start again, it flickers and it fails, and this is just a mess, okay? And you won't be able to get control back of your computer, unfortunately. And so what you should do in that case, if you really mess things up with the configuration files, is log into your computer from a remote computer, become the super user, and then type telinit 3 or telinit 2 or something to get it to a run level that doesn't run X Windows. So then X Windows would automatically be shut down. Now, to shut down your computer altogether, don't just type telinit 0, okay? And instead, use a command called shutdown. And let's look at the man page for shutdown. So man page, or the shutdown command, brings down the system. It brings down the system in a nice way. It spins down the disks. It makes sure everything's closed up correctly and so on. Okay? So this is the way that you want to bring down your system. And there's all sorts of options for shutdown. You know, the minus K option says don't really shut down, only send the warning message to everybody. The minus T option says how long in between the warning message and the actual shutdown. Okay, the minus R option says to reboot after shutdown and so on. Okay, and there's all sorts of things. You can force a filed system check on the reboot. You can cancel an already running shutdown. Okay, and so on. All right, so this just kind of gives you the option of shutting down your system. It warns everybody that's logged onto your system. You can give some warning message, and you can do all sorts of options like rebooting the system, file system checks, and so on. And this is the way you want to shut down your system, not with Telinet Zero. Let's talk about one more thing before we wrap up. We've seen that if we change the run level from, for instance, run level 5 to run level 2, a bunch of services are going to stop. Namely, those services that are not scheduled to run in run level 2 but were running in run level 5. But changing the run level is kind of an extreme measure just to stop some service. And instead, you can do what I'm going to show you right now to stop one service in particular. So I'm already in the Etsy directory, so let me go down to the init.d subdirectory of Etsy and do an ls there. And you'll see a bunch of scripts here. Now these scripts all control some particular service. The LPD script controls the line printer daemon. The sendmail script controls the sendmail program. The zinetd script controls the zinetd daemon. Okay? Now these scripts can all control those particular services, and you can stop, start, and restart those services with very simple commands. Okay? So now if you weren't in this directory, the way that you would do this is you give the full path name, like etsy init.d slash, say, LPD. And say we want to stop that service. So you give the LPD script the stop command, okay, just like this. You hit enter there, and it says stopping LPD, and then it says, okay, it stopped. All right? Now, if you want to start that service, you know, you can do it also, you know, because I'm in this directory, I can also do it with, like, the dot slash, like we did with our shell scripts. So I could say dot slash LPD, and I could say start, okay? And that starts the LPD service, okay? And there's one more command that you can do, is called a restart. It'll stop and then automatically restart. Sometimes the service just kind of hangs. It looks like it's running, but it's not actually working. And so you just want to stop it, but you'll want to automatically restart it. And in that case, you can just use the restart command to save you from typing stop and then start. So I do that, and it says stopping LPD, starting LPD, and so on. Okay? So any of these scripts in here can be stop, started, or restarted in this kind of a format. And this is the way that you want to do it if you want to stop one particular service. All right, well, it's time to wrap up another nugget. The main topic of this nugget was configuration files. We talked about user configuration files and system configuration files. And remember, we also call user configuration files dot files because they start with a period. So if you see something in a text or on the web about the dot file, they're talking about user configuration files. Then we moved on and talked about system configuration files, and most of those are in the Etsy directory and its subdirectories. And we talked about what the startup scripts were, what other kinds of scripts they called, what configuration files they used. And then in that discussion, we threw in a discussion of environment variables and also learned about the Etsy profile file, which was the place where you set environment variables for the system at large. And we also talked about run levels because they were important to understand some of the system startup scripts and what they were calling was based on what run level we were in. Well, I hope you found this nugget informative, and thanks again for viewing.